be it for a genetically restricted population. So we know the right patients to treat, and it'll be in patients who've had multiple prior therapies. And our focus is developing medicines that we think have tremendous benefit for patients. That's our focus. We're just working through our pricing strategy now, because we don't, and that will help us with our launch next year for ivosidenib. So we're taking into account all the factors out there. But our goal is to try and provide benefit, and we think price should reflect the benefit we provide to patients. Again, in a patient population where we know the right patients to treat based on a genetic marker.
Do you think it's a risky environment under President Trump, more so than it was before?
I don't think so. Not if you're focused on true innovation. If you're focused on first-in-class novel medicines like we are that really have a chance to just change the way we treat a disease. And if we're successful with our second medicine like we were with our first one, we're talking about decades of treatment of leukemia that's just been dripping in intravenous chemotherapy in your veins. To now imagine you're going to take a pill once a day at home and go into complete remission, that's a complete change in the way we treat the disease. So for those kind of medicines, we think the strategy is set.
Well, it's pretty amazing to think about. Dr. David Chung, guys, thanks for being here.
Thanks. Always a pleasure.
All right. Kelly, back over.